Natuurlijk.
Okay.
Come on, man.
Nature boy.
We will get to Andrew Luck in a second, but first, Niners Chiefs.
I did one of those cameos, do one of Ric Flair. Oh, $100, we get that in.
Oh, there you go.
Jimmy nice. Garoppolo finding Matt Breida in the back of the end zone. Nice grab by the running back.
All right, Jimmy G, nice bounce back game for him after a little 0.0.
That's his first completion since going out with the triple X model thing.
Okay.
I'm telling you, it is. It,
first completion, then also since he shattered his knee in that stadium.
Oh, same difference.
Saints and Jets and Drew Brees connecting with Michael Thomas, who makes an absurd leaping grab for
Let's
a touchdown.
Get it, Mike. $20 million back outside playing the Saints. Remember last year, week 12 through the playoffs, they struggled because Mike Thomas was playing inside the slot. Let's move him back outside and get that $20 million.
Cowboys and Texans, Dak Prescott escaping the pressure to hit Michael Gallup for the touchdown.
This is what you get, see? You get shamed our staff on the awesome Greg Olsen catch. Now we get a Dak Prescott very just pedestrian play. Oh, he escapes the rush. This is your fault, Chris Carter.
What do you mean? Dak right there, man, he avoided that sack. That could have ended his career. Man, these quarterbacks are brutal now.
Oh.
What are you talking about? That could have been the shot descending, man.
Back to Andrew Luck. His sudden retirement had a lot of people on the internet talking, some defending his decision, some criticizing. There was one player who had his back. Here's what Panthers wideout Torrey Smith had to say about the matter on Twitter. Any athlete in any sport that has had a major injury understands exactly where Andrew Luck is mentally. I'm still amazed that you can be criticized for doing what is best for you. See, how tough a decision was this for Andrew Luck?
It had to be gut-wrenching because we know on the surface as far as where he is right now, but almost every person that's a high achiever, if you talked to them about their childhood, if you talked about them when they were growing their teen years, what did you want to be? And Andrew Luck, man, as bright as he is, man, I'm sure besides saying a football player, his dad was a football player, football is the family business, or athletics with his dad being a former athletic director. I know Andrew Luck didn't see himself not playing NFL at 29. So to me, it's so, what does he do today?
Yeah.
I know what I'm going to do. I know what I'm going to do tomorrow. I know what I'm going to do the next 10 years, unless you guys get on my nerves. Okay. But what does he do? Because I know his life does not match up with his dreams and aspirations and moving forward. I know this. I know there's guys that I've seen, the athletes, and they didn't live up to their potential and the torment that they have. But this guy's career cut short, living up to, I mean, year number one, outstanding, getting the playoff. Year number two, we win a playoff game. Year number three, we're going to win two games. We in the AFC Championship. We getting ready to stare down Brady and the Pats for the next 10 years. Let's never been as successful, even though he bounced back last year. So I can't imagine personally what he's going through on a day-to-day. But it goes to show, no matter what type of sports you play, that's not who you are. That's what you do. And when he woke up this morning, that's his harsh reality. I'm not a football player anymore. And what does he do to be able to move on? I would hate to think, because for me, all my dreams have been about being a highest achiever at the highest level. And that's what the NFL is.
I want to talk about some of the criticism he's received. Because is it unfair? Sure, of course it's unfair. Everyone's allowed to do. You only live one life. And you should do what makes you happy as long as it doesn't negatively affect other people. And So of course the criticism is unfair. But we cannot simultaneously glorify athletes the way we do, using a lot of military analogies we probably shouldn't. Warrior, going into battle, fighting through injury. Those are all things that they're not neutral comments. They are celebratory comments. Talk about the toughness. And especially in this sport, where we give guys so much credit for playing through pain. And then expect immediately when someone says, you know what, the calf injury, it's too much. I'm done. And not expect there to be some, wait, what are you doing? Even if it's unfair, even if that shouldn't be the reaction, what we have culturally in this country done with athletes, particularly pro football players, is put them on the gladiator-esque pedestal. And so when you see one of the faces of the league walk away from the game, not because he was, to our eyes, knocked out of the game, not because he was multiple times concussed, not because, and by the way, of course it's better for him to walk away now than if that were going to happen. There's going to be some, wait, what? So I understand why that was for some people's immediate reaction, even if upon reflection, we should all wish the best for Andrew Luck. But it can't be the most shocking retirement we've had in 20 years and also universally praised by everyone the moment it happens.
But the truth of the matter is he didn't get much criticism. I think people were shocked. I mean, he didn't get much criticism. There's a few people out there, which there always will be, none that are important. So for me, Andrew Luck's decision, to me, it was one of the more positive things with the shocking news. I was around when Calvin Johnson retired. Man, that you know, people don't even know Calvin. They like Calvin. And he got criticized. And everyone else who's ever been, Robert Smith, my teammate, he walked away from after having 1,500 yards after the 2000 season and walked away from the game. And he was negotiating a long-term contract with the team. So the respect for athletes, it will always be there. And there's only a few things you can compare it to. But this is what I ask people, because pro football is not like any other sport. If you want to get a feel of what it's like, and you won't be able to do this because the NFL has banned most of it, not unless you're a former player, go to an NFL game and somehow stay on the sideline for 3 hours and 10 minutes. And you tell me after being on that sideline 3 hours and 10 minutes, I want you right next to the chalk. I want the guys falling at your feet. I want you to see what people go through. And quarterback, man, you couldn't pay me enough money to sit in the pocket and have guys tee off on me. Absolutely not. And I feel like I got a hell of a lot of courage. But that position and the way you can be brutalized, it's changed in the last few years. That's why the ultimate respect I have for the quarterbacks who played in the 60s, 70s, and the 80s, they the toughest dudes we got playing football. You remember some of the toughest guys we ever seen playing football because the rules change and you could brutalize them. These guys, it's easy for them, and the game is still not easy.
And one other point about how Andrew Luck did this. We all know he left potential future contracts on the table. But Peter King reported this morning, the Colts approached him about, hey, what if we put you on the short-term IR, give you 2 months to see if this recovers, and then you can make the decision. If he could have been retired in his mind and said, okay, I'm going to do that, and collected $22 million this year. He decided to do it in a way that not only obviously ends future earnings, but cuts off earnings that he could have had this season, and I don't think no one would have ever known that right. He had made the decision already. He did this the most professional way he possibly could have, and he now, to Chris' point, does have to wake up and say, man, I've always said I'm interested in architectural engineering. Am I going to go into a new career at age 29? Am I never going to work again? Am I just going to travel? Like, he's got another hopefully 70 years to live without the one thing that he's always done as his North Star.
No,
so
and
to speak.
There's for sure going to be a short-term identity crisis when you have been a part of this game for it is just who you are and who your family was, and now all of a sudden you wake up one day.
Yeah, imagine answering that question every day, no matter where he goes. Oh, you want to be architect or engineer? Okay, no problem. We have a project. Why you walk away from football?
Right. All right, we got to take a break. Much more on Andrew Luck and what it means for the Colts moving forward. That's next on First Things First.
Yeah, man. Not anyone important. It was pretty cool.